this might be the biggest surprise of my channel so far, but I actually like Taylor Swift. Who would have guessed? I actually like her. I believe I said like early in my videos that I can't stand her, but it was mainly because I was bandwagoning. And when you actually listen to the music, especially later, you know, Red 1989 era Taylor Swift, she's good. You know, she's a good artist. I cannot deny that. Yeah, this came out in 2014. It is her fifth studio album after the critically acclaimed albums such as Fearless and that other one that I can't think of right now. Yeah, Fearless and Speak Now, which were really critical acclaimed. Actually, Fearless got a 5-star rating on AllMusic. You know, 5 stars by 5-star by fucking AllMusic itself, by the staff, and 4.5 by the user. That is still really good though. That is a really good rating. Speak Now got 4.5, and Rest also got 4.5, I believe. Yeah, there we go. This one got 4, but I still think it's really good. So overall, this is a really good record, I would say. Really consistent, very catchy, you know. Really like the catchiness of records. This is probably my favorite Taylor Swift cover as well. You know, her kind of blurring out her eyes, you know, standing there with kind of a seagull kind of shirt with white fucking... how do you say that? With white fucking arm, I don't know how you fucking say that, but it is a pretty shirt, it is a pretty picture, so there we go. And then actually if you go to the back cover, you can actually see the remainder of her face, so that is kind of nice. She looks kind of weird though. She looks really pretty on the album cover. On the back cover she looks kind of vague in my opinion, but it's still a really nice cover. Probably my favorites, you know, Red is really nice. Speak Now is really nice, Fearless is nice. The self-titled one is kind of questionable. She's like 15 in that, so let's not go there. Yeah, so very solid album. We started with Welcome to New York. I believe requested by, you know, not the song, but I believe the album is requested by AllMedia Reviews, who is a big fan of Taylor Swift. And actually, you know, after I've listened to this record, I'm starting to become a Swiftie. Is that how you say it? I'm becoming a Swiftie. I actually like her, so there we go. We have Welcome to New York. We have kind of nice instrumentation on the opening track. You know, she's just kind of introducing you to the record. I do really like her opening style. 3.5 minutes, you know, it's not kind of generic. It is just kind of a nice poppy song. It's kind of synthy. It's just kind of, you know, classic pop in a way. It sounds nice. So overall, this was an enjoyable track. Definitely, you know, I can see her as one of those people that I, when I say I love a good pop song, I love a good pop band, I actually think that Taylor Swift fits perfectly into that, you know, and ABBA and a Blondie, I consider Blondie pop, Bee Gees, I guess, or the more disco, but Michael Jackson, you know, I actually consider her up with those people, so, you know, say that's ridiculous, say that's actually fitting, but I think it's fitting. And the opening song, you know, proves that. There's really nice instrumentation, really nice poppy feel, it is catchy, you know, the title's perfect for opening a song. So there we go, perfect opening song. Then we have Blank Space, which is kind of the most infamous song of the record. Fucking hell. I just really love, you know, the kind of the beats on there, produced by Max Martin and Shellback. So it really had some nice beats on there. I really like the lyrics by Taylor Swift. You know, she's kind of taking advantage over the over the psychopath character that she kind of possesses over the last years with her kind of obsessed boyfriend writing, which I don't really mind honestly, but if it's, you know, if it is a good song, it's a good song. So there we go. Yeah, that's some nice beats. I do really like the lyrics, you know. She's kind of, you know, taking advantage, like I said, over the psychopath's character. And we actually have a Death Note reference in here, I believe. You know, I have a blank play fucking hell, I have a blank space, baby. There's not one video where I don't fuck up. I have a blank space, baby, and I'll write your name. That's kind of, you know, suggestive, as in, you know, the show where she's talking about, I believe. Yeah, so that's kind of not, you know, people were bashing it because it's number one, and, you know, her true psychopath nature comes out of the song. But I actually was surprised nobody really mentioned the blank space reference. So that's kind of odd. But it's Taylor Swift, so there, of course, are a lot of things to talk about. Then we have style, which is exactly what the title suggests. And by the way, I love blank space. I love the hell out of blank space, so there we go. Then we have style, a really stylish song, you know, like you could have guessed, really conventional beats. It's just a really conventional song in general. Really catchy, really, you know, you know, the main word is conventional and stylish, and that is really all I have to say about the song. Really good tune, and check it out. Then we have Out of the Woods, which is a really underrated track in my opinion, or it's, you know, it was a single. It's an underrated single in my opinion. Really dark, really kind of, you know, suggestive. It is just a really dark track, you know. Dark is just the main mood that I have with this track. Just a lot of kind of dark and mellow natures on this track. Really enjoyed it. And it was overall a really pleasant experience to listen to, you know, more than I thought so far, actually. Then we have All You Have to Do Will Stay. I have to say that this is one of the few criticism that I have with the record, that All You Had to Do Will Stay, together with the next song, which is kind of the most infamous Swift song so far. This song is really repetitive, I believe. You know, there are some nice vocal melodies on there, and there are some nice instrumentations, but I think that overall the song is kind of repetitive. I believe she's saying the title over and over and over again, and I just don't enjoy that as much as I do with other songs by Taylor. But it was still a good song. It's only less than 3 minutes long, so it wasn't that bad. But it's still good though. So overall this is a good tune. Definitely, you know, caught into the biggest hits of the of the album, but it was still a solid song nonetheless. Then we have Shake It Off, which is the 3.5 generic, not per se generic, but kind of the obvious hit single of the record. Or the main lead single in a way. You know, I do like this song, but it is kind of generic, it is kind of dumbed down, it is kind of just that particular single. It's her most popular single so far, I believe. Which, you know, shows the power of her, you know, after 4 successful albums, still making your biggest hit to date, which is kind of impressive, for sure. But yeah, Shake It Off. I don't really like the lyrical content, you know. The haters gonna hate, the shakers gonna shake it off. It is just kind of repetitive for me. I didn't really like that. I do like the when you said it, the trumpet horns. I do like that when the trumpets are playing, when the instrumentation is playing. I do like that. I do still like Taylor's voice on there, but I think that the lyrical content really dumps it down and makes it one of the worst songs of the album. Which is still pretty catchy and pretty solid, so that only shows how good of an album this is. Then we have I Wish You Would, which is another kind of song that is cut between two behemoths of singles. I Wish You Would is kind of a nice, kind of mellow song, you know. Taylor's just saying, I wish you would do this, I wish you was like this, you know, I wish this, I wish that. So Taylor's just kind of demanding things from you, you know, to keep her as your boyfriend, which is not gonna happen because it's Taylor Swift. So yeah, I Wish You Would is just kind of, you know, the kind of fucking, how do you say that? It is just one of those songs where she's just kind of confessing and just kind of, you know, asking you to do this, I wishing. So there we go. It is a nice song, but it is just, you know, overshadowed by two behemoths of singles, like I said. And then we have Bad Blood, in my opinion the worst song of the album, but still pretty good. Most people think this is about Taylor Swift that it is about Katy Perry, which I don't really like. And you know, Taylor Swift has said over the record that that is not about Katy Perry per se, but it can be interpreted that way because, you know, they are the two biggest rivals in a way. The two biggest pop stars in a way, so there we go. I do still like this song. I do think that the Kendrick Lamar version is kind of, well, maybe better, but I don't know, it's kind of unnecessary to me. But yeah, overall this song just kind of, you know, it has the Max Martin and Shellback production again, so it is kind of loud and upbeat and kind of lousy as well. Which don't really matter, because I love it on Blank Space and I love it on some other songs as well. But I think that on Bad Blood, it is just kind of Bad Blood. I think it's just kind of, you know, generic on there. Kind of the similar reason with Shake It Off. It is just not really creative. It's just kind of there. I still like it. I still like the song. But it's definitely, together with Shake It Off, the two worst tracks of the album. Then we have Wildest Dreams, and going from the worst track to the best, I absolutely love Wildest Dream. I love the kind of, you know, dreamy nature of the record. I love the adventure, the coloredness of the record, the creativeness of Wildest Dreams. I love the instrumentation, I love the vocals by Taylor Swift, you know, when she goes like Wildest Dreams and she actually moans for a moment. Don't take that the wrong way. Do it if you want, but don't do that because it's a song, it's just a song. But I really do love, you know, that kind of moan that she has at the ending of the song. I'm not sure how you exactly caught it, but it sounds like a moan to me. I do really love that. It just sounds really adventurous, really like, you know, like she's peaking on something. It's probably the best Taylor Swift song I've heard ever, really. It's just a fantastic song, it's a fantastic dream pop song. It's just gorgeous. It's just gorgeous to listen to the even, you know, the title track, or even the track itself. The title is just amazing. Wildest Dreams just sounds really adventurous, really creative. Wildest Dreams, you know, whatever is happening in your dream, it are the wildest dreams. So it's just a fantastic pop song. If you disagree with me, fuck you. Comment me in the comments, because this is a great song. Now we have How You Get the Girl, which is just kind of another song with Max Martin and Shellback, kind of upbeat, kind of, you know, lousy produced. Not per se lousy is in a bad way, but I still like it. Yeah, and then, you know, basically Taylor Swift is talking about her obsession with the with the stalker thing, with the kind of Swift thing that she's doing. So I do like this song. It is kind of, you know, another Shake It Off, Bad Blood relatable thing. But I also think it's kind of similar to Wildest Dreams, so that is always a nice thing. A good song. I do enjoy it, but definitely need some more spins to explain this one. Then we have This Love, which is just kind of a solely written Taylor Swift song, which is just kind of about what you want out of a lover. And, you know, it's about love again, so there we go. It actually doesn't sicken me that she's talking about love again, but, you know, it can tire on me, maybe a little bit, but I'm not tired of it yet, so there we go. Yeah, so overall this is a pretty good song, pretty good pop song. It's 4 minutes long, and you have to respect that somebody can write a pop song about on 4 minutes, you know, because most people in the industry can't even write, and they can't even managed to make a 3 minute pop song. But Taylor Swift can do that herself and even make it 4, so give her kudos for that. She's a good songwriter. I wouldn't say one of the best, maybe one of the best of her generation, but not the one of the all-time fuck all Rolling Stones. She's good, but she's not that good. Now we have I Know Places, which is co-written by Ryan Tedder. Yeah, you know, same thing with how You Get the Girl. Good song, good solid song to listen to, but I think I just need a little more time to really explain this song. Still pretty solid, but it's just kind of filler in my opinion. Maybe take this track off of it and you would have had a better record, but, you know, that's debatable. And then we have Clean, which is written by Imogen Heap and Taylor Swift, or produced by Imogen Heap, I don't know. But I do really like the kind of mellow and the kind of subtle nature that's Clean as it sounds kind of, you know, haunted and kind of, you know, I'm clean on the record, I'm done here, I've cleaned it up, can I go now? It doesn't sound like half-assed or something, but it sounds like, you know, I've left my record clean. I believe there's actually a lyric on there that goes like that. It's a solid album, I did really enjoy it. And she leaves on a clean note, so that is always nice. I would say that the first kind of like 9 songs of this record are incredible. I really love the kind of the first, or I love like 3/4 of the album. I really love, and I think that the last couple of songs are still good, but they didn't really grab me. Welcome to New York, great opening song. Blank Space, fantastic song. Style, fantastic songs. Out of the Woods, fantastic song. I Had to Do a Stay, kind of Under Shadow, but still good. Shake It Up was kind of generic, but still good. I Wish You Would was kind of alright, but you know, it was between two behemoths. Bad Blood was the worst, but still, you know, still solid. So that only shows how good the record is. Wildest Dreams, probably Taylor Swift's best song, if I'm really honest. How You Get the Girl, yeah, solid. This Love, solid. No Place, solid. And Clean was, you know, a clean song to close it up. So this was an overall really good album. I haven't heard her other albums, but maybe if I re-listen to this record multiple times, I eventually think it's her best record. You know, because some people actually say it is her best record because it's the most, you know, poppy one and it's the most creative one. You know, because going pop isn't always a bad thing. In this case, it's fantastic in my opinion. So I'm gonna give this record an 8.4 out of 10. Maybe that's surprising to you because it's Taylor Swift, but I really enjoy this record, and you know, if you think that's weird, then fuck you. So there we go. Let me know what you think about Taylor Swift. Most people on my channel hate her, I believe, but you know, I believe I said her hater as well, but I actually love her now. So let me know what you thought about it in the comments down below. I've been Omnes, hope you have enjoyed this video. Like and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this one. Don't forget to subscribe to my All Music page, link in the description. My Metal Storm account, link in the description. And my other channel, Shadowruns, which I may record some videos on when I have some time off. Also in the description, so check out those channels down below. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Let me know what you think about Taylor Swift in the comments down below. And I will see you guys in our next video. God bless, safe, take care, and peace.